Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Here are 10 advanced copy and paste tricks. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So you think you know how to copy and paste on your Mac, and it's fairly simple. But there are many different advanced tips and tricks, and I bet you don't know all of these. So let's start off here in TextEdit. And you see I've got two lines here which have different styles. Now you can copy and paste including the style or paste not including the style. What's the difference? Well, if I were to copy this text here, Command C, and then go here to the end of this line and paste, you can see it retains the format that I copied. But if I were to instead go to Edit and then paste in Match Style, notice it's Option Shift Command V, then it just pastes plain text so it retains the style of the current paragraph. So think of the regular paste as including style and using Paste in Match Style as just including plain text, no style at all, so it inherits the style of the current line or paragraph that you're on. It's the same here in Pages, although Pages uses paragraph styles. So you can copy this and paste it into the same paragraph and it will pick up the style. But if I were to copy this, add a new line and paste this in, it retains that style. Or I could use Paste and Match Style and you could see it picks up the style that I started with that blank paragraph. You'll find this in Microsoft Word too under Edit and you'll see Paste and Match Formatting. Now when you copy and paste, you can only hold one thing in the copy buffer, also called the clipboard, at a time. However, there's a hidden second buffer that goes back to macOS's Unix-like roots. It's called Kill and Yank, and it's done with Control, not Command, but Control K and Control Y. So if I wanted to copy something, I could do Control K. Now it's going to do a cut, so it's going to pull that out. I can easily just undo to put it back. So now I can use Control Y to yank it back out of that second buffer. And you can see it puts it down there. And it's doing it as plain text, so it's picking up whatever styling is already set for this line. Now it's important to note that this is separate from the copy and paste buffer. So I've now got Quick Brown in the second buffer here, but in the clipboard I can then do a Command C to copy jumps over. So down here I can do Control Y to yank and then Command V to paste. And you can see how it grabbed each thing from its separate buffer. Control K also acts differently when you don't select something. So if you just put your cursor somewhere and you use Control K, it grabs everything from the current position to the end of the line. Now if you like the idea of remembering multiple items when you copy, so you have kind of a history of what you've copied, then you should get a Clipboard Manager. I have one called Cloud Clip that's right here and I can click on it and see the last few things that I copied and I can go back to any one of those. Here in the App Store, if you search for Clipboard Manager, you're going to come up with tons of them. Some of them are free. All of them are slightly different in the features that they have. So you should look through the ones that are available and find one that best fits your needs. For instance, here's Cloud Clip Manager that I've been using, but I like a lot of these others as well too and I've used many of them. So here's something I've been in the habit of doing for decades. And that is to quickly copy something before I submit it, usually in a web form. So say you've finished filling out a web form like this one and you're about to hit send. Now has this ever happened to you? You hit send and then you get an error message and try to go back but the text you typed is gone. Now you have to remember everything again. So what I usually do is when I finish typing a message like this, I do a quick Command A and then Command C. Just two quick keyboard shortcuts there. And then I hit send. And if all goes well, I just move on. But if something goes wrong, I actually have a copy of that in my clipboard now. I can paste it into the form for a second try. Now while we're here in Safari, let me show you how copying is not always clear cut. Sure, if I'm going to select some text, I just hit Command C and I copy. But what if it's something like an element on a web page, like this image? If you control click or use two fingers on a trackpad or right click on a mouse, you get the context menu. And the context menu has several different ways to copy from this image here. For instance, I could copy the link since its image is a link. I also can copy the image address, so the location of the image, or the image itself. So many different situations on your Mac, sometimes control clicking will give you more options for copying than just Command C to copy exactly what's selected. And I'm often surprised by how many Mac users don't know that you can copy and paste files and folders in the Finder. So here I am just looking at some files in my Documents folder. I can select one or more of them. I'll select two here, and I'll do Command C to copy. Then I'll go to another location, like into this folder here. Now I can use Command V to paste, and it will put copies of those items there. If I hold down the Option key, paste changes to move. So if you're looking for the Windows functionality where you can cut and then paste files, you can do that on a Mac, but you copy and instead Option Command V move instead of cutting and pasting. Now one of my favorite copy and paste tips has to do with taking screenshots. So if you do Shift Command 5, you'll bring up the screenshot interface here at the bottom. You can capture the entire screen, selected window, or portion of the screen. Now, if I want to copy this to the clipboard rather than saving it to a file, I can by going to Options and selecting Clipboard. But I don't have to actually do this. I don't even have to hit the Capture button. While I'm in the middle of setting this up, if I simply do a quick Command C, it will copy what's selected. So for instance, here in Mail, in the body of a message, I can now do Command V to paste, and it pastes in what I copied. Much easier to do screenshots that way, and it doesn't leave around a file that you later have to delete. Now sometimes apps allow you to copy more than just the text. You can copy the style. So for instance, if I were to select this text here, I could of course use Command C or Edit Copy. But if I go to Format, there's also Copy Style. That's Option Command C. And once I do that and I have copied a style, I now have Paste Style available. So now I can select some other text here and then go to Format Paste Style or Option Command V and paste the style, retaining the text. Here's a pretty advanced example of doing that in Numbers. Notice in this column here, the numbers include commas, but in this column they don't. They're using different styles. But if I select just one cell here, go to Format, Copy Style, then I double click the column there to select all of the numbers in here, I can now go to Format, Paste Style, and it adds the comma. You can even see it changed the cell formatting here. Now you can copy and paste between apps in really creative ways. For instance, here I am in Numbers, and say I like this chart and I want to show it to somebody. I can do Command C once it's selected to copy it, and I can go to a completely different app. Like for instance, here I am in Mail, and if I do Command V and paste, it's going to convert it to an image and paste it in. You could do the same thing, say, with photos. Let me select two photos here in the Photos app. Command C to copy. I'll hide that. Here I am in an email message. I could do Command V and it pastes both of those photos here into my message. I think this is the easiest way to add images to Mail. Yet a lot of people still mess around with file, attach files, and then go and find that file, or using functions in Photos to create the message in the first place. Just a quick copy and paste does it. Now let's say you lose track of what's in the clipboard. I'll copy this here, but now I can't remember what I copied exactly. There's a way to see what's in the clipboard. To do that, you need to switch to the Finder and then look under Edit, and there's an option for Show Clipboard. And this will bring up a little window and show you what's in the clipboard, even tell you a little bit of information about it, like this is rich text. This will work with images as well. So if I go to Photos here and select an image and copy, then I go back to the Finder and go to Show Clipboard, it'll even show me the image that's in there. So I've got one more bonus one for you. You can copy and paste between devices. This is called Universal Clipboard. Now to do that, you got to make sure you have everything set up to use Handoff on your devices. So you can go to this Apple support page right here, and then if you scroll down to Handoff, you can see all of the requirements for it. The devices have to be using the same iCloud account. They have to have Bluetooth and Wi-Fi turned on, although not necessarily on the same Wi-Fi network. And then there's settings for it. So for instance, on your Mac in System Preferences, there's a setting under General for Allow Handoff. But once you've got that set, you can copy something on one device, and then on the other device, you can paste it. And there's a time limit for that too. So don't expect to copy something and then much later be able to paste it. It usually has to happen within a minute or two. So there's a bunch of different things that a lot of Mac users don't know about copy and paste. I hope you learned something new. Thanks for watching. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.